the 1979 Sugar Bowl. Matching two teams battling on the field for the game that could mean the national championship. Number one ranked Penn State Nittany Lions, number two ranked Crimson Tide of Alabama. And it'll take place right here in one of the pieces of construction that's been called the marvel of the decade, the Superdome. Inside, warm and dry. Outside, cold and wet. For some of the offensive people, and right now, the Nittany Lions of Penn State have entered the Superdome, led by their coach, Joe Paterno. Ball teams, and here comes Alabama. Major Ogilvy returning it for the Alabama Crimson Tide, having won the toss, and Ogilvy is brought down by Giuseppe Harris. Rutledge, an obvious passing down, gets good protection, throws it to Eichner. Eichner comes across the 37, but he is cut down there, unable to reach the first down marker, replacing Ricky Tucker, who is out with injury. Chuck Fusina on an option. Chooses to pull it down, gets it out to the 20, fumbles the football. Alabama's defensive enough for Alabama at left halfback, out of the wishbone, with Whitman the fullback and Ogilvy on the right side. Rutledge looks, throws back across the field, set up a fullback screen over there with Whitman carrying. He's across midfield, and for the first time, Alabama is playing football on Penn State's end of the field. Oftentimes is the money man in this call. Rutledge pitches it back. He almost dropped it. Nathan gets outside. He's healthy. First down, Alabama. He's inside the 40 to the 39 at the Penn State 33. Rutledge to throw it. Kubin after him. He gets it away. It is dropped by Whitman. Whitman had the ball in his hands. He had Rick Neal there to the 33, the line of scrimmage. Since they missed the kick under the rules, they get it back out where it was snapped from. And Fusina goes over the middle. He's got Bassett. And Bassett has the ball first down at the Alabama 49-yard line. Brought down by Rick. No contact. Alabama is back. Fusina deep drop for the long pass. Goes over the middle. The pass intercepted by Murray Lake at the 33-yard line. A diving grab by the strong safety of Alabama. The pass was intended for Book. Third down, they need a little bit less than a yard. And Rutledge rides to his fullback. And Whitman breaks it. Steve Whitman goes down inside the Penn State 45-yard line. Back to the Penn State 49-yard line now, where it's first down and 15. Ogilvy. They are really getting some room over the left side of that Penn State defensive front. Lance Mayo made the tackle. It's third down now for Alabama at the Penn State 42-yard line. Neal goes out as a flanker. Rutledge hands it off inside to the fullback. And Whitman reaches the 38. There he goes down. Penn State still poor field position. Back at the 12-yard line. Fusina stands up to throw. He's got Bassett open, but he's running for his life. Now he dumps it. It is incomplete and almost intercepted. Murray Legg made a diving try for it. Fusina running for his life. Expecting pass. Legg drops back into a deep position defensively. The pressure is on. Tries to pass him. Hamilton got him. Wayne Hamilton, number 94, and Curtis McGriff, number 96. The linebacker Kraus blitzed and forced him to his right, and he ran right into Hamilton. State almost nothing on the ground so far in this first half. Handed off to Billy Jackson, and Bruce Clark's got him. Clark and Donaldson, but it was Clark who made the first.
He is a 226-pound senior, a little bit bigger. They want him for blocking.
Here's Fusina, straight drop to throw. Fumble. McGriff stripped him of the ball. No, it's Braggs who stripped him of the ball. Knocked it loose. Byron Braggs. And there.
16 yards. Just inside the Penn State 38. Rutledge on the option. Wants to throw the screen. Gets it away to Whitman. Whitman with three blockers in front of him, goes for the first down. And Jeff Rutledge, second down, seven. Rutledge to throw it, looking for Pugh. gets his pass off. It is intercepted. Intercepted by Rich Mullock. He may go. Only Ogilvy could bring him down. Only the foot speed of Major Ogilvy stopped Rich Mullock from going all the way. And suddenly, Penn State defense has been the story. Uchida straight back, looks for Fitzgerald, goes deep for Fitzgerald. In the end zone, it is incomplete. And with him all the way was Don McNeil, number 28. In motion. Uchida to throw. Bragg's got him and took him right out of field goal range.
Minutes ago. They're having a big problem with Bruce Clark, and they're going to start to double-team him all the time.
Hand off to Nathan. Nathan on the right side. Big play by Tony Nathan. All the way to the Penn State 37-yard line. The Georgia 25-22. Here's the pitch to Nathan. He cuts it back into the middle. He goes to the 30-yard line, and Alabama calls timeout. With fifth down and four. 15 seconds to play. Alabama with one timeout remaining. Rutledge on a roll. Looks down the middle, and it is caught. Touchdown, Bolden. The game comes with 8 seconds to play in the first half. The extra point is good. Alabama drops back now. They've got two center fielders back there. As Buscina sets up the throw, throws as far as he can, and throws it out of bounds. And time has run out in the first half. Score, Alabama 7, Penn State nothing. Jim Lampley is with Bear Bryant. State trailing 7-0 with the ball. First down at their own 20. Penn State offense has just been stalled. Buscina shoots it, passes, intercepted. Brought back by Jim Bob Harris. And here's Alabama knocking on the door. The freshman from Athens, Georgia. There's a penalty flag on the field. Rutledge swings it out short to Eichner. Missed by one, now he goes down. Actually lost on the play, back to around the 24-yard line. Great percentage. A hole by Jones. Got enough leg. Missed. Oh, he missed it. Off the... Alabama blitzing. They had red pass. Scott's after him. Kucinich passes away, and it's underthrown as Randy Scott was blitzing, and he got there. They had three people coming. It was becoming a bigger weapon all the time. Put it up. Intercepted by Pete Harris, who led the country in interceptions this year, his second. For third down and six. Buscina wants to throw, goes to Gooman. And Mike Gooman, who consistently figures in big plays for Penn State, takes the foot line thing called character. The 17, Buscina to throw it. Throws into the end zone. Touchdown. Butchke had 1 foot in the end zone as he caught the ball. That far for the extra point to tie the game. Drills it. 4:25 to go in the third quarter. Ball is back at the 17-yard line, and the Penn State defense is just raging right now. Millen again, number 60.
Boy, is he fired up.
That's Bassett wide to the top of your picture, out of the picture, and Buscina's looking at it. He's gone. Legs got him. Murray Legg, blitzing safety coming from the blind side, and he gets... And Fitz get a punch. Pretty good kick. Going to run Lou Eichner well back to the 27. Look at here.
great, great, great.
And Tim Travis, pair of tight ends in there on third down and 7. Rutledge just missed by Millen behind the line of scrimmage. It's Ogilvy. Touchdown. Major Ogilvy takes it in from the 8-yard line, and Alabama's back on top. And here's Alan McElroy for the extra point try. It is good. No flags, it'll stand. 21 seconds to go in the third quarter, third down at 8. You've seen his pass to the sidelines, complete to Gooman, and he's beyond the marker for a first down. So the Lions stay alive. It's Alabama 4-7. Deep drop over the middle, complete. The pass is caught by Brad Scoble, number 80. Brad, 34-yard line. It's second down and 16. Fusina on a deep drop going to the corner. Bassett's over there. It is incomplete. No, intercepted by McNeil. And Alabama will bring it out to the 20. Double coverage. Right now on 3rd and 5. Rutledge. Penn State's got it. Penn State's got it at the 19-yard line. Joe Lally, number 84. Ball was loose on the ground. It was a very bad pitch by Rutledge. The offense started to come alive. Second down and goal to go from the 6. Fusina on a roll to the right. Puts it up. It is good. Fitzke. And he is knocked out of bounds at the 1-yard line. And I want to tell you something, folks. There was one whale of a defensive play by Alabama's Don McNeil. Suey dives. He didn't make it. He got about a half of it. To go for the touchdown and the possibility of tying or going ahead for Penn State. 19-game win streak, only undefeated team in the country, ranked number 1 in the nation, Alabama ranked number 2. Everything could be hanging on 4th and goal with a half a yard. Gooman. Score is 14-7, and the clock is running at 4.5 minutes to play in the game. That's Major Ogilvy. Every time an Alabama back progresses up the field, this
is it right?
Up the middle. Out to about the 34. Fullback Whitman. They send on the punting team. And 6. 3rd and 6. 1:59 to play. This could be it. It's a screen to Gooman. He's covered. He breaks it outside. He dives for the marker. He doesn't get it. He's going to be short of the first down. They've got to go. Otherwise, out several teams claiming it. Fusina back to throw on first down. Throws to the sideline. The pass is caught by Gooman. And Gooman fights his way down to the Alabama 44-yard line with 1:38 to play. That is another first. 1:28 to play. 3rd down and 7. Fusina goes deep with it. Goble is out there and can't get it.
They say Murray Leg is always Johnny on the spot, and I believe him.
Oklahoma's playing Nebraska. Ball skitters back to Woody Humphrey. They make the run at the block. It's a poor kick. It goes out of bounds with 12 seconds to play. So Penn State's going to get at least one playoff, maybe two. They're close, if not there, when it's all done. Over the middle it goes. It is up there. Is the fourth interception by Alabama, and there are people all over the field. One more time. As he hunts elusive number one. There's your last play of the ball game. It is over. Alabama has defeated Penn State by a score of 14-7. Alabama has won six times in the Sugar Bowl, and the Bear goes for a ride. Into that melee, trying to find Paul Bryant to shake his head.
Well, you just hate in a game like this to see anybody lose.
Alabama story, and it's going to be an Alabama party tonight that is going to make this old town jump.